Hey everybody, welcome back. This video is about occupational dosimetry. That is monitoring the dose to healthcare workers who work with ionizing radiation. Occupational dosimetry is necessary because United States federal law limits the amount of radiation that can be received by a healthcare worker during the year. The annual effective dose limit to the whole body is 50 millisieverts. The purpose of this limit is to minimize the probability of stochastic effects like cancer. The limit to the lens of the eye is 150 millisieverts for the year. The purpose of this limit is to prevent radiation-induced cataracts. This dose limit is much higher than the whole body dose limit because cataract formation only takes place at much higher doses. The annual skin and extremity dose limit is even higher at 500 millisieverts. The purpose of this limit is to prevent deterministic effects, which are only possible at very high doses. For members of the public, the dose limits are all 10% of the occupational dose limit. So the annual effective dose limit for members of the public is 5 millisieverts for the whole body. The annual lens dose limit for members of the public is 15 millisieverts. And the annual dose limit for the skin and extremities is 50 millisieverts. Please note that there is one exception to this rule. 5 millisievert is the whole body limit for infrequently exposed members of the public, like visitors at an imaging facility. A lower limit of 1 millisievert applies to frequently exposed members of the public, like clerical staff and others that work near radiation but not with radiation. When we're talking about occupational dosimetry, remember that not all radiation dose a worker receives during the year actually counts towards their occupational or working dose. Here's an example. During the course of a year, a radiographer receives a dose of 3 millisieverts in the X-ray control room, 10 millisieverts while working in fluoroscopy, 32 millisieverts from a series of back surgeries on himself, and 4 millisieverts from radiation exposure in his own home. What was the worker's total occupational dose? So occupational dose includes the dose from the control room, that's 3 millisieverts. It also includes the dose while working in fluoroscopy, which would be 10 millisieverts, but it does not include dose from background sources in their own home. It does not include the dose from their own medical procedures. So this healthcare worker's occupational dose for the year is 3 millisieverts, plus 10 millisieverts, which equals 13 millisieverts. Personal dose is tracked by wearing a personal dosimeter, and there's two types: thermoluminescent dosimeters called TLDs and optically stimulable luminescent dosimeters called OSLs. All personal dosimeters have the same function. They're worn by the operators to track their dose over a period of time. Certain people must wear a personal dosimeter. So here's the rule. Occupational workers that may exceed 10% of their annual limit. So this would include almost all healthcare workers who work directly with ionizing radiation. It also includes radiologists, and it can include other staff that might exceed 10% of the annual limit. In order for the dosimeter to provide accurate readings, it must be worn correctly. So here are the rules. Rule one is wear it. The dosimeter should be worn at work, always at work, and only at work. Rule number two is wear the dosimeter at the correct location. Dosimeters should always be worn at the collar, and they should be worn outside of protective lead apparel. Wearing the dosimeter anywhere else can result in an incorrect dose report. Expecting mothers wear an additional dosimeter called the fetal dosimeter at the level of the waist, and it's actually worn under the lead apron, and that makes sense since that's closest to the baby at the level of the waist. So what's on a dosimeter report? Dosimeter reports look way more complicated than they actually are. They usually include the dose report for the past quarter, they include the year-to-date dose report, and they include your lifetime total dose. They also break the dose for each of these categories into smaller categories based on the occupational limits. So there's the deep dose, which corresponds basically to the whole body dose. There's the eye dose, which tracks dose to the lens of the eye. And there's also the shallow dose, which tracks the dose to the skin. So what's done with this information from a dosimeter? The law requires that your dose be evaluated by a qualified expert, such as a health physicist or medical physicist. Also, the dose reports have to be made available to occupational workers on a quarterly basis. So that's an overview of occupational dosimetry. Let's try a quick practice question. What individuals are required to wear an occupational dosimeter to track radiation dose? The correct answer is A. Workers who may receive 10% of the annual limit must wear a personal dosimeter.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.